very special edition of WCW Worldwide Wrestling. I'm Tony Schiavone. Jesse the Body Ventura is on assignment this week, and I'll be joined in commentary by the Executive Vice President of Wrestling Operations of WCW, Cowboy Bill Watts. And later on in the program, Cowboy will join me as we'll take a look at what happened just last weekend at the Great American Bash. Fans, we have a new WCW World Heavyweight Champion. It's Big Van Vader. He defeated Sting last Sunday at the Great American Bash. We'll show exactly how he did it a little bit later on in the telecast. Also, Dr. Death Steve Williams and Terry Bam Bam Gordy became NWA World Tag Team Champions, winning the tournament. We'll show you footage from that championship match a little bit later on as well. You saw at the top of the program, Brad Armstrong is a new light heavyweight champion of the world. We'll see Brad Armstrong in action against Tracy Smothers. Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes are here in tag team action as well, and we'll see the Barbarian and Dangerous Dan Spivey together. But right now, some of the great light heavyweights in action in our first match this week on Worldwide.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one to my right, first from Nashville, Tennessee, weighing 208 pounds, Richard Morton. His tag team partner from Palm Beach, Florida, 227 pounds, Scotty Flamingo. And their opponent, first from Marietta, Georgia, weighing 234 pounds, Marcus Alexander Bagwell. And his partner from Cincinnati, Ohio, 226 pounds, Flying Brian.
Okay, like we said at the top of the program, we welcome Cowboy Bill Watts here to WCW Worldwide. The action is hot in WCW here in the month of July, Bill. And here we go with a great tag team match to begin things out.
Certainly right, Tony. I mean, these are four top light heavyweights. It's exciting to see them. You know, when you come in and catch weights or matching weights, it requires a lot more technique and a lot more conditioning. Oftentimes, a heavyweight has a unique strength factor, or he has a unique skill factor, and he always has his size to get him out of trouble. These guys have to rely on really perfecting technique.
Holding onto the rope, Flying Brian, the other side. Double headbutt that time, and now both men in. Back body drop, both sides. And a drop kick. Out goes Flamingo. Out goes Richard Moore.
What a difference in the height on drop kicks when you do the comparative one between Bagwell and Brian Pillman. I can see why they call him Flying Brian. His power in his legs for his vertical leap is tremendous.
At one time, Flying Brian was a light heavyweight champion. Scotty Flamingo, of course, held that title as well. Richard Morton has been a top contender, as well as Marcus Alexander Bagwell, really the youngster of the four men in there.
Well, we really want to develop this division. I think it's an exciting division. I think the fans love it because of the action, because they're all so similar in size. And with our relationship with New Japan Pro Wrestling and the tremendous junior heavyweights, look at that move. Look at them feint each other out.
Double axe handle blow. Side headlock. Here comes Flamingo. Lion Bryan has both men hooked. Head scissors. Takeover. Great agility that time. Goes right after Morton one more time, and here comes Marcus Alexander Bagwell. Bagwell, standing side headlock on Richard Morton. The youngster's really come a long way since he first came into WCW about a year ago. Right hand to the face, though, and you're talking about veterans, Bill, in WCW. Richard Morton is really a veteran of tag team wrestling.
Well, yes, Ricky at one time being a world's champion with his partner Robert Gibson. The times move on and things change. And if you don't stay up with the intensity and the conditioning, you're just not going to be on top.
Bagwell will make the tag to Flying Brian after he nailed Morton. Morton comes right up with a foot. First man to get the blow in that time. And now, slipping from behind, Flying Brian ropes him up. One, two, three, we got a winner.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners. The team of Flying Brian and Marcus Alexander Bagwell.
We talk about the quickness of the light heavyweights. In the bat of an eye, Flying Brian has rolled him up, and his team gets the win here on Worldwide in our first event as we take a look at the replay.
That's right. He's got him behind in the waist lock. Ricky tried to hang onto the ropes, but he couldn't quite get his hands locked, and he pulled him on back for the pin. Notice, let's see if Flamingo comes to try to help his partner. He sees he's in dire straits, but he was a little late, and there's the victory.
Winner, Marcus Bagwell, Flying Brian. We go to WCW Magazine.
I'm Eric Bischoff, and this is the WCW Magazine. The three-time All-American Ron Simmons, the inspiration, the athlete that has set his sights so high here in WCW, has got another obstacle in his path. This time, that obstacle placed in his way by former seven-time World's Heavyweight Champion, Harley Race. The obstacle's name? The Super Invader. We're going to take you back and show you exactly what's transpired between the Super Invader and Ron Simmons. But first, let's get these comments from Harley Race and the Super Invader.
Simmons, you may be the greatest football player of all times, but you're not on a football field right now. You're in a wrestling ring, and you're in a ring with a man that's capable of taking you apart, and take you apart is exactly what he's going to do. This man right here knows more about wrestling than you'll ever dream of, Simmons. So when you walk in the ring, come prepared for a beating, because a beating is what Super Invader is going to give you.
Well, the former seven-time World's Heavyweight Champion, Harley Race, appears to have a knack for discovering some of the most dangerous athletes ever to step inside of the squared circle. And certainly the Super Invader fits that bill. Now, later on in the hour, I'm going to show you what happened when Jesse the Body Ventura attempted to interview Ron Simmons in front of a national television audience. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this has been the first edition of the WCW Magazine. Stay with us, wrestling fans. As always, the action continues right here in WCW.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, being led to the ring by the First Lady of WCW, Medusa. He's from Robbinsdale, Minnesota. He weighs 252 pounds. The United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude. His opponent from Lexington, Kentucky, 203 pounds, Larry Horry.
Cut the music. What I'd like to have right now is for all you fat, out of shape, Midwest meatheads, keep the noise down while I take my robe off and show you what a real sexy man is supposed to look like. Hit the music.
Well, the fans obviously not too appreciative of what he had to say right there, Bill, but you can't deny the U.S. champ. He is quite an athletic specimen. Take a look at that.
That's for sure. He doesn't have much body fat. The man maintains his conditioning, and of course, he certainly has his nerve, or his way of letting you know kind of that he's on top of the situation. I think sometimes in a match when he does that little grind there that he does, that he's so proud of, that he's really taking a chance, but he seems to want to stick it in just to let the guy know he's not really concerned no matter what the conditions are. Wrestling, like any other sport, has a lot of intimidation factor. This young man right here, Larry Corey, has got to be a nervous wreck facing the U.S. champion. I don't care who you are, when you get up against the people that you already know have the reputations, they've already proven themselves in the ring, even when you're a top man, you're really nervous. And so this young man here, it's certainly a big opportunity, but he's got to first overcome the battle with himself, and that power slam didn't help him any.
Picks him up with ease, the power of Ravishing Rick Rude, and Medusa there ringside cheering her man on. There's the grind you talk about. There's a man out there by the name of Nikita Koloff who is hot after that U.S. heavyweight title. He's a former U.S. heavyweight champion. What a match. I'd love to see Koloff and Ravishing Rick Rude go at it. And holding the man up now with a bear hug, just pulling right on that lower back.
That's right, and that's a powerful hold in the area. And, of course, we've read some of the fan mail, and some of the people were upset about Koloff and how he treated Medusa. But my feeling is this. If Medusa is out there in the capacity as a valet, it's one thing. But when she interferes with a match, which she's done on numerous occasions, when you put yourself in a man's place, you're going to get treated like a man. And I think Koloff only did what anybody would do that's seen some of these things and been the brunt of some of these situations. So I don't believe that is really a negative on Koloff. I think if Medusa doesn't want to be involved like that, she should stay out of the way. And there's Rude going for it, and that's it.
That's right, the Rude awakening. The cover, 1, 2, and 3, and that's it.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the United States Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude.
Many people say it'll be the Rude Awakening versus the Russian Sickle. When you get right down to it, it's going to be two great athletes.
Well, and they both attack the same part of the body, the spine connecting to the skull, the top vertebrae. As you see right here, the Rude Awakening. Look where it's locked in. Look where the shoulder is. It's just like a whiplash in a car wreck. And this is a very, very effective thing. It can cause unconsciousness.
Your winner, the U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Ravishing Rick Rude, getting set for the big match against the Russian Nightmare, Nikita Koloff. We'll come back on Worldwide right after this. Time out.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Charlotte, North Carolina, weighing 241 pounds, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat! His opponent from North Park, Florida, 249 pounds, Bob Cook.
Okay, set to go in the next match, Bob Cook and Ricky Steamboat. And before the match gets underway, Bill, we're going to take a look at some footage back from Beach Blast and that brawl that ensued between Ricky Steamboat and Cactus Jack.
Well, certainly, Cactus Jack, probably one of the highest played instigators or bounty hunter types, snatched Ricky Steamboat when he was making an interview after Ricky had just come out of a 30-minute Ironman match. But Cactus Jack and also that same Beach Blast had that falls anywhere, and it was almost like a match in a parking lot with Sting, and he proved one thing to me, that he has no personal regard for his own body's safety and certainly doesn't respect anybody else's.
And that's something that Steamboat will have to look out for when Steamboat and Cactus Jack tie it up in the ring. Right now, Bob Cook goes to the ropes and Steamboat breaks away.
Right, he had a hammerlock and Cook went to the ropes. That's a sign, number one, when you go to the ropes if you don't know the way out of the hole. And Bob Cook's pounding him. I mean, he's just teeing off on Ricky.
Reversal, Irish whip to the right side, Steamboat down and then up with a leapfrog and a arm drag takeover.
Ricky Steamboat is poetry in motion to me. He's one of the ones I tell the young men in wrestling to watch. He does everything with perfect technique, perfect conditioning, perfect timing. Some guys are unorthodox. They've just been given a gift from God where they have an unbelievable physical ability. They're unorthodox in style, and if you copy them and can't do what they do as far as your training, as far as your tactics, you're at a loss. But Ricky Steamboat has perfect technique. You always want to scout and watch the guy with a great technique because that's something that anybody should be able to use. As you see him, he always reverts back to wrestling. There, drop toe hold maneuver, but you see Ricky spins right under that arm. When the guy reached over, you don't reach over in wrestling. When you reach over, the guy on bottom with his good technique is out, and then there he goes into the hammerlock. And now this is a unique thing of his own as a way of putting additional pressure and leverage on the left shoulder, the shoulder that's behind Bob Cook's head there. That's where he's really putting the pressure on Bob Cook. And the referee's asking him. There have been guys that have submitted in holes just like that. See, look at him. He's got that hand. It's above a 45. Right. That would be illegal in amateur wrestling. But in professional wrestling, you can take it right on home. You can stick it in their ear if you want to. Now, reverse half Nelson. Now he's really put the jeopardy on Bob Cook. The biggest thing is, all Bob Cook can think about right now is how to get out. He can't think of anything on offense or anything else. His entire energy is spent on how do I get out. He couldn't figure a way out. He climbed to the ropes, and Ricky's back on top and in control of this match.
It's being in control of your opponent that led Ricky Steamboat at one time to being the World Heavyweight Champion. And I know, as we said at the top of the program, now that Big Van Vader's the champ, Steamboat would love that title shot.
Well, a lot of people are coming into the picture right now, people that WCW haven't even heard from in a long time. As Bob Cook, you see, he knows he can't beat Ricky wrestling, so he now is trying to out-brawl him. But I tell you, Ricky Steamboat's been around a while at that, too, and his technique there again is classic. He's got that explosion. He's got that confidence. And look at him. I mean, he's just devastated the man.
He's got the cover, the one, the two, and the three. And that's exactly what he did, bro.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Ricky the Dragon Steamboat.
Steamboat gets the big win as we take it out of the magazine.
Eric Bischoff here with another edition of this week's WCW Magazine. Earlier on in the hour, we heard from Harley Race and the Super Invader. And we talked about the situation that happened in front of a national television audience when Jesse the Body Ventura tried to interview the three-time All-American Ron Simmons. Well, Harley Race and Super Invader were standing by and they decided that was an opportune time to launch their attack on Ron Simmons. We'll hear from Ron Simmons later on in the hour. But before we do that, take a look at this.
2000. This ain't the 18th century, and my name ain't Gopher. And if you won't sting, you go get him yourself.
Let me tell you something, Mr. Simmons. 7 different times I was world's heavyweight champion, and I had a boy like you carrying my bag.
Well, that was too insulting. What a distasteful remark. And Simmons has got to fight them both. The Super Invader hammering away at Ron Simmons. Race with that left hand. They're both double-teaming Simmons. And Simmons kicks Race in the midsection. Oh, what an elbow and a clothesline. Simmons will fight them both. Football tackle, and Race goes down. A clothesline. The masked man goes down. Ron Simmons is no messenger. He is an All-American.
Now, if that wasn't enough, just a few weeks after that incident, the Super Invader and Harley Race, like two criminals, returned to the scene of their crime. But this time, things didn't turn out so well for the Super Invader. Take a look at this footage.
Well, I think Rod Simmons is ready to do it right now.
Wait a minute.
The Super Invader seems to be ready.
Not now. Now's not the time. Let me tell you something. I told you before. You may think you're tough, you may be tough, but you're not a pimple on either one of them.
Well, Race just got the taste knocked out of his mouth by Ron Simmons. Simmons is not going to listen to that. From behind, it's the masked man, the Super Invader, and Harley Race now double-teaming Ron Simmons. Simmons being hammered here by both men. He missed it.
Where will this situation end? I'm sure that depends on who you ask. And later on in the hour, we're going to find out from Ron Simmons exactly what he thinks about the Super Invader and former World's Heavyweight Champion Harley Race. Stay with us. The action continues.
Wrestling fans, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Austin, Texas, weighing 261 pounds, the Natural, Dustin Rhodes. His tag team partner from Sweetwater, Texas, 278 pounds, Barry Windham. Their opponents, total combined weight, 484 pounds. First from Trenton, Georgia, Pat Rhodes. Seattle, Washington, John Peterson.
Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes, two young men that should take a look at many of their fans out in the arenas. Two young men who have the last great American Bash, of course, this past weekend, really went right to the finals against Doc and Gordy. What a match that was. They had to wrestle 3 matches in one night, Bill, and that was really a lot for them.
Well, it certainly was, and all 3 of theirs were grueling matches. And, of course, Doc and Gordy only had the 2 because they had been boosted ahead in the quarterfinals at the Clash, where they had defeated probably the number one team in the tournament, the Steiner Brothers.
Barry now sending Rhodes over, going after Rhodes once again. The aggressiveness of Barrett, of Dustin Rhodes, that is. I'm drag takedown.
A great young team, and Dustin and Barry, and of course, they've got the height. And a lot of people don't understand how much height helps you in wrestling. It increases your leverage. It's also when somebody shoots in on your legs, you always seem to have a reach and a different factor on them, and it makes it an advantage to you once you learn how to use your height. And of course, they have great teamwork via that clothesline maneuver on the tag.
That's
he
it.
Rips up the leg and sticks the flanker in, 1, 2, 3.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winners of the match, the team of the Natural, Dustin Rhodes and Barry Windham.
Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes got the win with the lariat from the reverse side that time. Tremendous win, and we'll be back with more right after this timeout. We're set to go with our next event, the WCW Light Heavyweight Champion of the World. That's Brad Armstrong against Tracy Smothers in what should be a great match. We saw Brad at the top of the program winning that light heavyweight title from Scotty Flamingo. It was a great win at the Omni in Atlanta, and he's a tremendous athlete and certainly deserves everything he gets.
Well, that's right. And, you know, Brad's from another wrestling family, his dad, Bob Armstrong. It seems like these kids that grow up and they watch their father, they see the pressure he's under, they see the stress, they also see the training. And oftentimes young get into that type of training. They seem to have a great love, a deep, deep love for the wrestling. And they'll pay the price to get themselves in a position to do it. And that's what Brad's done. I was talking to him about his winning the light heavyweight title July the 5th in the Omni. And, of course, I was on the card in the Cadillac tournament in 1973 when his father won the first big tournament ever in the Omni in wrestling in Atlanta. And Brad was in the audience, and his dad got put in the hospital by Bobby Duncombe. He won the match, but he had a detached retina and a brain concussion. And big Bobby Duncombe. And Brad said, I was there, and I saw it. He said, I cried when I saw what my father went through. And here he is now, light heavyweight champion of the world. He won it in the Omni in Atlanta. A proud young man, a great young athlete. And of course, it's a division that's lightning quick. A lot of things happening. And Brad's going to leave right away for another trip to Japan. And the competition over in Japan for his title is really intense. You got Jushin Liger. There's so many of those fine junior heavyweights and light heavyweights in Japan, as well as right here with Scotty Flamingo, Brian Pillman, and those people you just saw earlier on that tag match. And, of course, he tried to tilt him for an inside cradle, drop toe hold. Brad showing his wrestling ability up into an arm bar. You see a lot more of the combination-type wrestling with the lighter weights. You see right there, he's got the hammer lock with an arm bar-type thing. Now he sticks it over into a quarter Nelson. If he clears his body back over, he's got a half Nelson. But, of course, he's on the same side as you see him holding the hammer lock in. So that's another pinning combination. And the biggest thing about it, oftentimes you think, well, that's not doing any good. You haven't got him pinned. But you've got that guy thinking of nothing but how to get out of the hole. He can't really project into an offensive concept at that point.
Good takedown, Brad.
Good takedown.
And drop a drop hole. Yes, sir. And, you know, Brad is going up against a man, Tracy Smothers, who's had a lot of success in this division, Bill, as well. At one time, he was a tag team champion at WCW, but a lot of success now in the light heavyweight division for Tracy Smothers.
Well, Brad is consistent, and again, he's got good technique. He's in good condition, and he's proven he's got the heart. High cross body block.
Got a two count out of that, and a drop kick right out of it with a great drop kick. Andre, take over one more time, right back with the arm bar.
And you notice that drop kick, the tremendous vertical leap where he was horizontal, and yet the feet landed right on Tracy Smothers' chin. You'll see a lot of difference in the quality and the height they get on those drop kicks. And they're a high-risk maneuver, but you've got to be up high where you really have the leverage factor in your behalf at that guy's highest point when he's on the run or when he's moving.
Working on that arm again. Drives a knee right down to the arm of Tracy Smothers. Randy Anderson is our referee watching in now. Checking with Smothers here. It's the fans, you can see the fans love Brad Armstrong. Such a nice, personable guy. But right now, he is really working on Tracy as he tries to go to the shortcut to the hair.
Well, I know that Sting, certainly with Big Van Vader being the new world's champion, anytime a world's heavyweight champion changes hand, it's the biggest event in the sport. And Sting certainly is number one in line, and he took it to a new level and proved why he's the champion. But Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and Bam Bam Terry Gordy have both said they'd like to sign for a world's title match against Big Van Vader. I'd like to get some of these rough guys against each other, too. As you see, Brad looks like he might have got a little ripped on his nose, and he's trying to hammer lock in and hold on right now and regain the momentum there.
Once again, brought Tracy right down with a drop till hold. Goes to the arm one more time, takes him over, hanging on to the arm. Now with the head scissors applied.
Well, what he took him over with was the hammerlock positioning there, as he had that arm and that shoulder in such a bind that Tracy literally had to go.
Tracy trying to reestablish the vertical base. Both men are back up one more time.
But Brad is staying with the tenacity of staying with one hold. You see again that technique and that game plan, because that takes its toll on Tracy Smothers. So Tracy now is trying to come back and take advantage of Brad in a different way, and that was a great move right there by Tracy Smothers. Brad just was a little too confident. When you have the guy's leg up, go ahead and stick the trip in and get him back down on the mat.
Tracy using martial arts background with a like a savant kick that time. One, two, and out of two count.
I think the reason Brad was able to come out of that is you saw his hand got in there between the actual toe of the boot or the flat of the foot and his face and took most of the brunt on his hand and into his face. It stunned him, but it didn't put him out. Right there. There is his patented move.
One, two, three. Russian legs. We've got the win.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Brad Owens.
strong.
And Belly executed that Russian leg sweep in the midst of a flurry by his opponent that time. Just showing you he can put it on at any time.
Well, it's a fantastic maneuver. And as you see, he's got the leg looked. He's hooked. He's got the whole thing. He kicks the guy's leg out. And the move as they hit, he's already topped. He's got his leg, Tracy Smothers' leg, so he can't kick out.
Brad Armstrong, the light heavyweight champion of the world, gets to win on Worldwide. And we'll have more fans. Stay right with us.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing team number one. Introducing first from Odessa, Florida, weighing 303 pounds, Danny Spivey. His tag team partner, parts unknown, 295 pounds, The Barbarian. Their opponents, total combined weight, 474 pounds, Knoxville, Tennessee, Larry Cento. From Rock City, USA, Scott Allen.
Spivey, The Barbarian, immediately go right after their opponents. And sent Allen on the outside, keeping Santo on the inside. These two big men in WCW now, they just have the size, Bill, and they are vicious.
Well, yeah, Danny Spivey played football at Georgia. As a matter of fact, I was on the plane the other day with Mac McWhorter, one of the assistant coaches. And he played with Spivey, and I think Coach Goff did too. And they said he was a tough athlete until he blew out a knee at the University of Georgia. Of course, he's rehabilitated it now, and he is an impressive force. This guy right here, The Barbarian, that's a different piece of machinery right there. That's a look at the tremendous explosion he has. He kicks it into a new gear. Watch the follow-through he has as he drives into this guy. Everything he does shows that a tremendous explosion, follow-through, of what makes the great athletes. And of course, here's two guys that came in after, and they were looking for a shot for the world's title against Sting. And now you have Big Van Vader's the world's champion. What does that do to them? Well, as far as I'm concerned, I want to book some of those matches. I want to get some of these tough guys against each other, because certainly I want Sting to have the return bout, and I'll personally be pulling for him because he proved to me the heart he has. He is the WCW former world's heavyweight champion, and I think the WCW championship, without a doubt, is the one that has the highest level of competition for the world today. But I also believe some of these tough guys ought to get out there, and when they're kicking and booting like that, they ought to get a taste of their own medicine.
By the way, speaking of Big Van Vader, the world heavyweight champion, will be here next week on Worldwide. We'll have an interview with him. Maybe we'll ask him about some of the men who I'm sure are standing in line to try to get that world heavyweight title shot.
Did you see how high he elevated this young man before he did that backbreaker? With one arm, he just practically just pressed him up and dropped him on his knee. This guy here is a powerhouse.
Sending Allen back down again. And a chokehold applied there. Referee right on him to warn him of that.
Well, the referee's not on him well enough. I want to speak to Ole about that. We're trying. It takes a long time to get these officials where they have the backing and the confidence to get in there and do some of this. I noticed he even started the match when the two guys were attacking the other two guys. You know, there's a lot of things we have to do, and we read the fan mail too. We can't win the match for the wrestlers in the ring. We just want everybody to have the same advantage. And the officials are not going to be the difference, but we want them to be consistent. Fall away there. That just had to dislocate every spinal joint in his back. And, of course, like a predator that he is, the Barbarian knows how badly he's just injured the guy there.
And the big foot right behind the head. Wow.
Well, and that was a different type of a martial art kick, too. He went up above and came driving down on the spinal cord of that man. And I think the guy he's finished.
Yeah, he really is. Fans, will have the world tag team champions, Doc and Gordy, with us next week in tag team action against Flying Brian and the Z-Man. And there's the powerbomb by Dangerous Dan Spivey. Covers him and gets the three.
Well, if you saw that powerbomb by Spivey, then you just multiply that by another 100 pounds by Big Van Vader, and that's what happened to Sting.
Spivey!
We are going to be showing you the footage of what happened to the Great American Bash after the break. So, fans, stay with us right now. Dangerous Dan Spivey and the Barbarian with an awesome win here on Worldwide. When we come back, we'll take a look at what happened at the Great American Bash. Stay tuned.
I'm Eric Bischoff for the final edition of this week's WCW Magazine. Earlier on in the hour, we heard from Harley Race, the manager of the Super Invader. And then we saw footage, the vicious attacks of Super Invader and Harley Race on the three-time All-American Ron Simmons. Quite obviously, Simmons and the Super Invader have got their sights set on Ron Simmons. But now it's time to give equal time to the three-time All-American Ron Simmons. He's standing by right now, and he's got these thoughts about the Super Invader.
Harley Race, you were a great champion in your time. And it's not unknown to everybody that you did whatever it takes to get there. Now you're bringing another man in here, and you're giving him the same ideas you had. And now you want to use Ron Simmons to get there. Well, look, it won't happen. I'm afraid that's going to be cut short, buddy, because I've got plans. My plans are to prove to the people that Ron Simmons is who he says he is, and that is somebody worthy of being the world champion. And I'm going to show them if it means going through you first.
Ron Simmons knows that he's an inspiration to children around the world. Ron Simmons has set his sights so high here in WCW, and he has vowed not to let any obstacle stand between him and his goals. But the Super Invader at 287 pounds is definitely a force to be dealt with, and Ron Simmons has the tools to deal with that problem. I'm Eric Bischoff, and this has been this week's edition of the WCW Magazine. As always, the action continues here in WCW.
Tony Schiavone along with Cowboy Bill Watts from Albany, Georgia, the site of a great American bash. What an event it was. Dr. Death, Steve Williams, and Terry Bam Bam Gordy are NWA World Tag Team Champions.
That's right. It's always hot in July, but it's really been hot in the WCW. And Doc and Gordy have got all the gold, but they've created lots of enemies. And I'm sure they've got the Steiners rededicated to the mission of getting back at them.
Fans, let's go back to Albany right now, the scene of the NWA World Tag Team Tournament Championship. Doc and Gordy win the belts.
Dustin Rhodes trying to fight his way out of the corner of his adversaries here. This would be, what a, look, he fights, this kid just, he keeps fighting.
Well,
what a flurry.
I'll tell you, gutsy move by the young guy, but he gets cut off again. The veterans that they are and the best tag team, in my opinion, in the world.
Irish whips him in. Dr. Death got him up, takes him to the corner. Dr. Death takes him to another corner, carrying the 260 around, going for the stampede, but Wyndham with a drop kick. Rhodes on top. One, two, and Williams kicks out.
Smart move there by Barry Windham's. Dr. Death holding Dustin Rhodes up a little bit too long. Windham outside the ring, battling it out with Bam Bam Gordy. Whoa, and Williams misses head first into the buckle.
Dustin trying to get him in the bulldog, but Doc shot him right off, and Dustin ran right into Gordy. On the outside, he's fighting with Windham. Oh, clothesline. Doc turned him inside out.
It's
with
over.
A clothesline. He hooks the leg. And one, two, three, they've done it.
What a physical matchup that was in that championship match against Barry Windham and Dustin Rhodes, but they came out the victors.
Well, they have the bulldog tenacity and all the skills go with it. They just wear everybody down.
Fans, I had a chance to talk to the new champions right after the match. Here's exactly what they said.
They have all the gold, and I tell you what.
We brought the gold home, baby. We've got the gold. And you know what? The executives, the lawyers from Japan, are they excited now? Call in the hotline, buddy. We're going to call and tell everybody we are the champion, NWA, WCW.
Tag team champions of the world, sir.
Well, there's no doubt about that, you know. We told everybody time and time again what we was going to do. We went out and we did just that, Tony Schiavone. We brought them all home. We have got all of it right here, and it's going to be a long, long time before you find the team that can beat this one right here.
It was a tremendous tag team tournament, but also the WCW World Heavyweight title was decided. One of the greatest world title matches I've ever seen, Bill.
You know, that's four titles the month of July that have changed hands. Four world titles. I want to say, Sting, you're the world's champion with heart and courage. Your game plan was perfect. But split seconds is what separates it in world's championship competition. And Big Van Vader, 450-pound, a huge juggernaut, is the new WCW World's Heavyweight Champion.
Let's take a look at the footage.
Introducing first the challenger, accompanied by seven-time former World Heavyweight Champion, currently race. He's from the Rocky Mountains. He weighs 448 pounds. Big Van Vader.
There is a challenger.
Go man.
And ladies and gentlemen, from Venice Beach, California, weighing 250 pounds, he is the WCW
Stinger.
Here he comes, Jim Ross, the champion.
And he's got the little stingers here. The signs all over the Civic Center. Youngsters with their faces painted. The posters. Big forearms. Oh, my. Tremendous forearms. High impact blows by Big Van Vader on the Stinger, already taking their toll on the heavyweight champion of the world. Vader's backed him into the corner. The referee's got to break this thing up. And Vader again catches Sting in the corner. Sting has got to stay away from the corner. Irish whip, move the whole ring, but Sting quickly moves out of the way. Oh, yeah! A suplex! And wow. Shut the ring! And shut the rafters! A close line! Solar plexus, and Sting hit again. You don't know internally how much this high impact style of Vader affects the champion.
Boom.
To what degree? Another elbow drop.
And that's a 450 pound elbow coming down. He's gonna measure him for another one. Look at Vader just measuring him, taking his time.
Sting blocks it, cuts back to the right hand. Martial arts, blows by the Stinger. Going for some momentum. He caught him off with a move, and then a move by the Stinger.
Sting laying in those kicks three and four times on Big Van Vader.
He's trying to get him up. What's he gonna do here? Vader's 448 pounds. Sting's got Vader up on his shoulders. Can he hold him? He's got the huge man up, the champion. With all the strength in his body, with Vader up on his shoulders. Look at Stringer. What's he gonna do here? Oh, what a slam! Vader and Sting. Oh, my. Sting hit his head. He hit his head on that steel railing there, Jess. That hook is right by his left arm, his right arm.
Both men. Vader sitting on the seat of his pants in the center of the ring. He's not sure where he is. Sting literally draped over the top rope. Almost, I think he's unconscious.
Sting hit his head on that steel support. He's bleeding. Sting hit his head on that steel support. The champion is hurt. He hit his head on the steel. Oh, my. Oh, my. This will be all. He can't get up from this one. Yes, he can. Yes, he can. What do you think about the champion of the world? Battered and bloody, but he got that shoulder off. This guy will not quit. He hit his head. I saw it as clear as day. Right on that steel support. Oh, he's in a weakened state. Look at that big. Oh, he's in trouble. He's hurt. He is hurt.
And Vader's measuring him.
He may have a concussion. He slapped that steel, and it didn't give.
Sting had everything going his way. He had the chance to win it, and one move has cost him and cost him dearly.
Vader, Ray's calling for the powerbomb. And, oh, God! He just planted him with a powerbomb, and Vader has won it!
So Big Van Vader is the man, the heavyweight champion of the world.
And he may be the most awesome physical heavyweight champion that's ever been in the history of wrestling. Without a doubt, he's a force to be reckoned with.
After his win, he had a chance to talk with Eric Bischoff.
I am
with the new World's Heavyweight Champion, Big Van Vader. And let me start off with you, Harley Race. You had to be shocked, like everyone else, at the power of Sting.
What do you mean, shocked? It went just like it was supposed to be. This man is the greatest athlete on the face of God's green earth, and we just showed every little stinger out there that the myth is gone. The myth has been destroyed. This is the king of athletes, the king of wrestling. The man in wrestling today is Big Van Vader.
All right, how about it, Van Vader? Already people talking about the rematch between you and Sting. Will we see a rematch, Van Vader?
Do me. The pain game has been taught. The lesson has been learned. And brother, the pain game is over for Big Van Vader. Stands on top of the world. The heavyweight champion of the world. Ha ha! Yeah!
Well, wrestling fans, they talk about history here at the Great American Bash. This one may go down in history as the only heavyweight title match to show up on a Richter scale. So, Bill, it's just like you said at the top, things are heating up in the month of July in WCW.
The intensity amazes me. I guarantee you these athletes are just going all out. Four world titles have been affected in the month of July. This is the most awesome situation we've ever been in. You, the fans at home, are the beneficiaries because you get to watch it all and be a part of it.
For Cowboy Bill Watts and all of us at